President, please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
President,
the chamber now issue its oral ruling on request to rescind order
E319/7/3.
The chamber is seized of a accused and defense request supported by the co-prosecutors to rescind its order
E319/7/3.
That order, one, required that all testimony of any individual who testified in cases 003 and 004
ayant fait une déclaration dans le cadre de l'instruction du dossier 3 ou 4 ne soit entendu, soit entendu avec
required that questions to any witness
que l'interrogatoire de tout témoin sur la base d'une déclaration faite dans le dossier 3 ou 4
also be heard
soit également conduit
à huis clos. Session. The international co-investigating judge initially requested such an order,
que soit rendu
but
telle ordonnance,
has since stated that
mais a déclaré depuis
it is no longer necessary.
Que ces mesures n'étaient plus nécessaires.
The co-prosecutor and the defense team for Kilsom Pond maintains their statements and their submissions, and other parties do not raise any new concerns. Pursuant to Article 34 new of the ECCC law and Internal Rule 79.6, the accused has a fundamental right to a public trial. The chamber also considers it to be in the interest of justice
dans l'intérêt de la justice
and judicial committee to respect the requirements of confidentiality of ongoing investigations. As the international co-investigating judge no longer deems it necessary to hold all of the above discussed testimony in closed session, the chamber reconsiders and reverses its order in
E319/7/3.
The chamber's prior ruling in
E319/7
shall remain in force and effect,
demeure en vigueur.
Subject to the following additional guidelines
et assujetti aux lignes directrices suivantes.
The ICIJ has requested, in addition to the procedures set forth in
E319/7,
that the chamber require the use of pseudonyms for any case 003/004 witness or civil party who testifies in case
002/02.
This protective measure is narrowly tailored, permits the chamber to continue in public session,
n'empêche pas que l'audience devant la chambre continue
d'être publique,
et ne limite pas de façon abusive l'interrogatoire des témoins.
And does not unfairly limit the questioning of witnesses.
Des témoins.
See document E319/7, paragraph 11 to 12. Therefore, the chamber orders the use of pseudonyms for such witnesses and civil parties.
Ainsi l'utilisation de pseudonymes pour ces témoins et ces participants.
The ICIJ has also indicated that he will request visual assessments for individuals whom he considers may require additional protective measures for their safety or security. The chamber notes that the right to a public trial must be balanced against the need to protect the identity of witnesses and victims.
l'accès public et le besoin de protéger l'identité des témoins et des victimes. 29, et en application du règlement de la règle 29 du règlement intérieur et de l'article 4.1 de la directive pratique measures, sur les mesures de protection,
the chamber will apply la any protective measures ordered
mettra en œuvre toutes les mesures de protection qu'ordonne le Bureau des cours juges d'instruction pour des témoins des dossiers 3 et 4.
Finally, the ICIJ requests that a relatively small group of witnesses to be identified in the in future be heard in cross-session and that the chamber respect other unspecified measures for such individuals. The chamber will communicate through the ICIJ concurrently with the parties in case 002/02, the list of witnesses, civil parties, and experts selected to testify on each topic until the ICIJ has identified which of these individuals should be heard
in closed
session. Mais tant que le juge
d'instruction internationale n'a pas encore identifié lesquelles de ces personnes devraient être entendues à huis clos,
cannot fully assess
la Chambre
this last
ne peut
request.
Évaluer pleinement cette dernière demande.
This constitutes the Chamber's
voici
official response
la réponse
to
officielle de la Chambre
E376 and E376/1. The chamber will proceed with the hearing in public session of witness 2TCW918. However, the chamber notes that witness 2TCW918 has been questioned in an ongoing investigation. The International Co-Investigating Judge has suggested that a pseudonym be used for such witnesses to protect the confidentiality of the investigations. The Chamber considers that this limited protective measure is warranted and that such properly balances the need for a public trial with the need to protect the integrity of the investigations. The parties are further reminded to respect Order E319/7 for the use of case 003 and 004
pour l'utilisation de déclarations émanant des dossiers 3 et 4.
Court officer, please usher the witness and his duty counsel into the courtroom. I notice the international co-prosecutor on his feet. You may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just one clarification for future witnesses regarding the first category of witnesses identified by the international co-investigating judge and the use of pseudonym. Our question is, in the case where the witness are asked by WESU, do you have any objection to your name being used in public session? And the witness indicates that they do not have any objection to their name being used in public session. In that case, it seems to us, perhaps Your Honors can clarify this at some point, that the pseudonym would not be necessary if the witness themselves say they have no problem with their name being used in public session. And if I could just make a very quick note on, well, I certainly agree with the defense submission that the right to a public trial is a right of all accused persons. We made that point in our filing. But it's also, in our view, a right of all parties and the public. Internal Rule 79.6 does not limit it to the accused. The accused can't decide to close a session on its own. The Karadzic Protective Measures Decision of 26 May 2009, paragraph 11, recognizes the public interest in a public trial, as does the European Court of Human Rights case, Predo versus Ors, Predo and Ors versus Italy of 1984.
Thank you.
Merci.
And the Defense Counsel, focus on point, you may proceed.
Oui, je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
dans la suite une demande de clarification du côté de la défense. Je ne sais pas si c'est moi qui ai mal compris, mais est-ce que nous sommes d'accord que pour les témoins, pas de traduction.
I don't get an English translation, nor does anybody else. You do? Four? Okay. No, four is completely disturbed in my... Three? Okay.
Donc, je recommence.
I'll take it again.
Une demande de clarification par rapport à votre décision. Je ne sais pas si c'est moi qui ai mal compris, mais est-ce que nous sommes d'accord que pour les témoins qui étaient témoins dans le dossier 02-2 avant d'avoir été entendus par les coachs d'instruction, est-ce que nous sommes d'accord que eux, il n'y a pas d'utilisation de pseudonyme a priori à avoir puisqu'ils sont d'abord et avant tout témoins dans le procès 02-2? C'est la précision que je
so I want you to clarify that matter, whether it's all the witnesses in case 002/02 who have to be heard in that manner.
I didn't hear your request because I didn't get the whole translation.
Je n'ai pas entendu ce que vous demandiez car je n'ai pas entendu toute l'interprétation.
Je vais retourner une troisième fois. Donc la demande de clarification que j'ai est sur les témoins qui étaient témoins dans 02-2 avant d'avoir été entendus par les co-juges d'instruction. Est-ce que nous sommes d'accord que la question du pseudonyme dans ce cas-là n'est pas nécessaire puisqu'ils étaient avant tout témoins dans 02-2 et ont des déclarations qui ne sont pas soumises a priori à une confidentialité dans la mesure où ils ont été renvoyés devant la Chambre comme témoins 02-2? Donc c'est la précision que je souhaite avoir sur ce dernier point pour que ce soit bien clair pour la suite.
Properly understand.
Dom Jay. Yes, the co-prosecutor, you may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just wanted to add to something on the issue that Kyusampan's counsel has raised. Your Honors asked a question on this very issue to the International Co-Investigating Judge in a memorandum you sent, a question that I had too, which was, do we need to use pseudonyms for anyone who's given a case 3 or 4 interview, or only those who were exclusively known through the investigations? You received a response that said that it would be primarily for those who were exclusively known through the investigations, but there may be some cases where it would extend to others. So the situation we're in right now, if I surmise, is that we haven't heard from the international co-investigating judge about his position on this particular witness. Under that circumstance, I assume that we would proceed with a pseudonym. However, if it is possible for our officers, one of your clerks, to communicate with OCIJ, I think there is a possibility that because this witness gave his first interview to DC CAM and was learned of by everyone, including ourselves and OCIJ, through his public DC CAM interview, this may be a witness for whom the international co-investigating judge does not have concerns, and therefore we don't need to worry about pseudonyms. But I recognize we may not know that at this time. So I just wanted to add that because I think that is partly in response to the question that counsel has raised.
President.
Le président.
In practice, our proceedings will based on our oral ruling with a judge read out.
La chambre va employer les mesures qu'elle doit expliquer dans sa décision.
Witness, in order to
et avec ce témoin
balance
aujourd'hui, toujours pour respecter cet équilibre
and the
entre les
confidentiality of the ongoing investigations
et la confidentialité des instructions en cours,
by the international co-investigating judge,
the
proceedings will be in public. However, pseudonyms shall be used in relation to those statements. For future proceedings, the chamber will consider the matter on a case-by-case basis.
La chambre le fera au cas par cas.
And that is also based on the request by the international co-investigating judge.
Fonde aussi and pour cette décision sur la demande présentée par le Conseil de l'Instruction
Internationale. In the future proceedings, if it is worthwhile to hold the proceedings in closed session. However, based on the current estimate, there is only a minor instances where hearings shall be in closed session.
Il n'y aura que quelques exceptions, quelques cas exceptionnels où il faudra avoir des audiences en huis clos.
The changes in the restrictions requested by the international co-investigating judge.
De position du co-juge d'instruction internationale.
However, the changes is within the restriction that not all the proceedings shall be held in a public. We need to consider the matter on a case-by-case basis for all the witnesses in case
002/02,
as we had to consider the matter of the confidentiality in the ongoing investigations in case 003 and 004.
Le président poursuit.
President, I'd like to proceed with the initial questioning of the witness, that is to TCW
918,
due to the protective measure and the use of a pseudonym.
Compte tenu des mesures de protection qui ont été retenues, l'utilisation des pseudonymes, monsieur le témoin de TCW 918 est devant nous.
Please refer to the identity information in the document before you,
qui vous avez sous
that
les
is
yeux,
Ian in Khmer
001-003140,
president, and
il s'agit de votre fiche d'identité.
Take the document to the witness, and you do not need to respond in microphone, just inform the greffier whether the information on this page is accurate. And duty counsel, please assist your client.
Avocat de permanence, veuillez aider votre client.
President, Mr. Witness, upon reading the highlighted portion on this page, can you inform the court whether the information is accurate?
Witness,
good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame.
The information is correct.
Ces informations sont exactes.
President, thank you.
Merci.
Greffier, please
Madame la greffier,
remove the document from the witness.
Le document.
And Mr. Witness, the greffier made an oral report that, to the best of your knowledge, you are not related to any of the two accused.
Vous n'avez aucun lien avec
there
les
is no G and Kirsten Paul or any of the civil parties admitted in case 002. Is this correct?
That's exact.
Witness, réponse. Yes, that is correct.
C'est
I am
exact.
Not related to
je
any of them.
Avec ces personnes.
President,
président.
Have you taken an oath
avez
before the Iron Club statue this
la
morning?
Statue du génie à la barre de fer ce matin?
Witness, yes,
réponse, oui.
I have. President,
le
the
président.
Chamber would like to inform you of your rights and obligations as a witness regarding your rights. As a witness in the proceedings before the Chamber, you may refuse to respond to any question or to make any comment which may incriminate you, that is your right against self-incrimination. This means that you may refuse to provide your response or make any comments that could lead you to being prosecuted. Now, on your obligations, as a witness in the proceedings before the Chamber, you must respond to
plus,
any questions by the bench
or
relevant
parties,
que les juges ou les parties except posent. Where your response or comment to those questions
si
may incriminate you, as the Chamber has just informed you of your right as a witness. You must tell the truth that you have known, heard, seen, remembered, experienced, or observed directly about an event or occurrence relevant to the questions that the bench or parties pose to you.
Souvenir, en relation avec les questions qui vous ont été posées.
Mr. Witness, have you been
Monsieur
interviewed by the investigators of the Office of the Co-Investigating Judges? If so, how many times,
si oui,
when and where?
De fois, où et quand?
Witness, I have been interviewed at the Prenepréa district, at my own house, and I think there were, it happened two or three times.
C'était deux ou trois
I cannot
fois,
recall it
je crois,
exactly.
Je ne m'en souviens pas parfaitement.
President, thank you. And
président,
before
merci.
You appear before the Chamber, have you reviewed or read the written records of your statements that you were interviewed two or three times at your house in Prenepréa district in order to refresh your memory?
Ont été colligés par les enquêteurs deux ou trois fois dans votre maison après notre prière pour vous rafraîchir la mémoire.
Witness. To my recollection, I cannot recall everything from the written record of interview, and that's also related to my current health condition.
Dans les
President,
d'audition, et cela
my
aussi
question
un
to
lien
you
avec
is
mon
whether
état
you
de
have
santé.
Read the written records of your interview or have them read
si
aloud to you
si on vous les
in relation
lu,
to what you told the investigators at your house in Prenepréa district in order to refresh your memory.
À votre maison, après un prière pour vous rafraîchir la mémoire.
Answer.
réponses.
Yesterday, I read those statements.
Je les ai lus hier.
And also have them read aloud to me.
Et on les a lus à voix haute.
And that, of course, helped to refresh my memory.
Et cela m'a aidé à me rafraîchir.
President, thank you. And to your best recollection, can you tell the chamber whether the written records of your interviews that you have read them and that you have them read out to you, consistent with the statements you provided to the investigators at your house?
Aux enquêteurs du bureau des juges d'instruction qui sont venus chez vous?
Answer. Yes, they are consistent.
Oui.
They are mostly consistent with what I said.
Pour la majeure partie,
however, some portions are not consistent.
Mais certaines parties ne correspondent pas.
President, thank you, Mr. Witness, and
Le
you are now being assisted by
Merci.
A duty counsel through WISU.
Un avocat qui vous a été fourni par la section d'appui aux témoins et aux experts.
Duty counsel Mom Rottier.
Mom Rottier.
And for questioning this witness pursuant to Internal Rule 91B, the floor will be given first to the co-prosecutors before other parties. You may proceed, co-prosecutor. And the combined time for the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers is 1 day.
D'une journée à deux. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci.
Good morning,
Monsieur
Mr. Witness.
Dit le procureur. Bonjour, Monsieur le témoin.
My name is Dale Lysak. I will be asking you some questions today.
Je vais vous poser quelques questions aujourd'hui.
And I wanted to start with some questions about your background, positions, and your work history before and during the Democratic Kampuchea regime. I'll be asking you some questions later about the Trapiang Tama Dam, but I first wanted to ask you about your experience working on construction of dams before Trapiang Tama. Can you tell us, identify for us how many or the names of the different dams that you worked on, that you helped to build in the years 1974, 1975, and 1976, prior to the time you worked at Trapiang Tama?
First, I worked at a dam at Phnom Kombao, and that extended
Phnom Kombao,
to Sre.
Qui est allé jusqu'à Sre.
The length of the dam was 13 kilometers.
Le barrage mesurait 13 kilomètres de long.
And the dam was put in operation after the completion. Second, I worked at the Kopromchek Dam.
Ensuite, je suis allé au barrage de
it extended to Smatcha,
qui allait jusqu'à Smatcha, Kuteng,
to the east,
à l'est.
And to the west,
et
it was to Tin
il allait
Kam commune, with it,
la commune de
which
Tin
was the adjacent of Phnom Srok and Prenet Preah districts.
À Phnom Srok et Prenet Preah, les districts de Phnom Srok et de Prenet Preah.
The third dam that I worked on
sur lequel j'ai travaillé
was that my team was reassigned to plant cotton trees at another work site. And the fourth work site that I worked at,
et ensuite le quatrième site sur lequel j'ai travaillé,
was that I was assigned to measure
était un endroit
land
où
in order to build
affecté
road
à
l'arpentage from Sangrang
pour construire des routes
to the Noid, to
the
west, that is towards the Cambodian Thai border.
Vers la frontière entre la Thaïlande et le Cambodge.
After that, I was assigned to work at the Trappist-Mort Dam, which was the last work site that I worked at the time.
Thank you. I'll come back and ask you some questions later on the two dams that you mentioned before Trapping Tama, Kambo and Kok Ram Chek. I wanted to ask you, though, whether you also worked on a dam in 1974, a dam called Taku Dam, that was in Mongol Beret District. Did you also work on the construction of that dam?
Sur ce, contribué à l'édification de ce barrage.
Answer. I started working in that work site in 1974. It was a small work site. I worked there to get water for the field.
Can you tell the court how the Khmer Rouge got workers to assist in the building of that dam?
Answer. Concerning Gombao Dam worksite.
Réponse. En ce qui concerne le site de travail de Gombao,
workers were selected from districts and communes. There were female and male youths, and some were from Phnom Penh.
Certains venaient de Phnom Penh.
They were evacuated from Phnom Penh to live in the villages and communities and cooperatives, after which they were sent to work at that dam site.
There may have been some misunderstanding, Mr. Witness. I was not asking you about the Kambo Dam. I was asking you about the Taku Dam that you worked on in 1974. Can you tell the court how the Khmer Rouge got the workers who built that dam?
Ont obtenu, ont trouvé les travailleurs qui ont construit ce barrage. Réponse.
Actually, they were people living in the forest.
À vrai dire, c'était des gens qui habitaient dans la forêt.
They were in the rear battlefield, and
ils
these people were
sur le
older,
champ de bataille arrière,
were the elderly, adult, and adolescents. Not so many people were sent to work at the Takiu dam site.
Que cela sur le site du barrage de
were there people who were arrested and sent to work
question,
at that dam?
Qui ont été envoyés sur ce barrage était-elle arrêtée?
But me and Pichichun, Majanun, Nelton Bong Trey. Some people
réponse.
Who went to fishing and who used to.
Certaines personnes qui allaient pêcher.
Be in the Lunos area were mobilized by Khmer Rouge to work at that dam site.
Pour aller travailler
after
sur ce site de barrage.
A few days, they escaped.
Après quelques jours, elles se sont échappées.
Do you remember how many
question.
People
vous souvenez-vous du
were arrested and sent
ont été
to work at the Taku
et
dam?
Qui ont été envoyés sur le site du barrage de Taku.
President, please hold on, Mr. Witness. You may have the floor now. Counsel Kong Samon. Counsel Kong Samon. Mr. President, I would like to register my objection. since it is not within the scope of the debates before the chamber.
La question posée
and regarding the timeline and the location alleged in this case,
l'endroit et le
they
lieu
are not within the scope of the trial. The witness mentioned the fact that happened in 1974,
effet,
which is not within the scope of the trial in our case.
And Mr. President, if I may respond, the purpose of these questions is because the policy and practices of the Khmer Rouge, the CPK, in establishing work sites is very much an issue. And this evidence, the fact that people were arrested and sent to work at a dam site, establishes that this was not, this is relevant to the enslavement issue, relevant to the fact that people were did not have a choice to work at dams. So I don't intend to spend any time on this. I simply wanted to get some indication from the witness of the scope of the practice of arresting people and forcing them to work at this dam.
The objection by the defense counsel for Mr. Kyu Somphone is overruled.
Par la défense de Kyu Somphone est rejeté.
It actually is outside the scope of of the trial in terms of the timing and location. However, the questions are related to the policy of the Democratic Cambodia, and the chamber instructs the international co-prosecutor to put only a relevant question and some question only, not a broad question on the matter. Mr. Witness, you are instructed to give your answers
Monsieur le témoin, veuillez répondre.
To the question put by the international co-prosecutor, and if you do not recall, you can ask the co-prosecutor to repeat it.
Vous pouvez lui demander de la répéter.
Witness, I cannot get what you said, Mr. President.
Mr. President, let me also focus the witness particularly on a prior statement he made that may get to this quickly. In an interview you gave to DC CAM, this is document E3/9094, a Khmer ERN 00734039-040, English 00728647-648, French 0112-3611-12. You made the following statement, quote, and this is in regards to the Takyu Dam, quote, as construction was going for a while, those who were from Prenet Pre were arrested. Continuing below, question, when they were arrested, where were the people taken to? answer, they were taken to help build the dam. And on the following page, quote, as they arrested more people in Pray to help build the dam, my forces were taken to dig up the road in Mekchaba. End of quote. Does that refresh your memory, Mr. Witness? Can you give us some sense of the number of people that were arrested from Pray Net Pray district and sent to work at this dam?
Et que l'on a envoyé travailler sur ce barrage.
I cannot recall the numbers of people who worked at the dam site.
Je ne me souviens pas du nombre de personnes qui travaillaient sur le barrage.
Let me move on to your positions during the Democratic Kampuchea regime. You describe in your DC CAM interview how you were initially a member of the Pray Net Pray commune, responsible for supervising and assigning youth from July 1975 to January 1976. And at that time, you were appointed to be the deputy chief of the Sector 5 mobile forces. My question, who was it that appointed you to be deputy chief of the Sector 5 mobile forces?
No one appointed me to be the deputy chief.
Personne ne m'a nommé chef adjoint.
In fact, I was in charge of measuring the land.
Je devais mesurer
going around and observe the land and arrange the workforce. I was not appointed to be the deputy chief at that time.
Perhaps
the people who interviewed me may have misunderstood me. I was not the deputy chief. When Daval was absent, he would ask me to be, you know, in charge of the task that I have just told you.
M'occuper de la tâche que je viens de vous décrire.
Let me try to refresh your memory with a couple of statements that you made, Mr. Witness. In one of your OCIJ interviews, E3-9483, and this is in answer number one, you made the following statement, quote, I was deputy chief of Sector 5 mobile unit, which was under the supervision of Sector Committee Chief named Tahong, end of quote. And you said the same thing in your DC CAM interview, E3/9094, Khmer ERN 00734049, English 00728654, French 0112-3618, where you said, gave the following evidence. Question. In January 1976, you were recruited to be deputy chief of a regional mobile unit. Who appointed you at that time? Answer. Our colleagues, not anyone else. We were called to see the secretary of the region. He was preparing the work at the battlefield directly. He said, it was up to you, and I've omitted your name, here. It was up to you, Mr. Witness, to supervise if Taval is absent. If Taval was there, Taval was the supervisor. If not, I was. End of quote. Does that refresh your memory, Mr. Witness? Is it correct that the sector secretary Tahong appointed you deputy chief under Taval and instructed that you were to supervise when Taval was absent? Is that right?
Answer. Back then, I was not appointed to be the deputy chief. As I said, when Taval was absent, he asked me to supervise. I replaced him. However, I did not fully supervise all the work. I was responsible for some tasks in the replacement of Taval.
Lorsque Taval n'était pas là.
I was called the commander of the battlefield, which means that I had to go around and supervise the workers at the dam site.
Les travailleurs sur le site de travail.
Can you tell us, Mr. Witness, what your position was then in the Sector 5 mobile unit? What was your position? Were you a battalion commander, a regiment commander? What position did you hold?
Quel était votre poste, votre position?
I was referred to the commander of the battlefield within the sector mobile force. And under me, there were only six people. I was not in charge of hundreds of workforce. And concerning the workers, those who carried the dirt, dig the dirt, they were under the chiefs of regiment, battalion, so on and so forth. And I was only assigned to go around and observe people who worked at the dam site.
De circuler et d'observer les gens qui travaillaient sur le site du barrage.
In 1976, when you were working on the Kambor and Kuk Ramchek dams, and in 1977, when you did work relating to Trapiang Tama, what was your relationship with Taval? Did you report to Taval? And how often would you meet with him?
Lui rendiez-vous des comptes? Lui présentiez-vous votre rapport et à quelle fréquence le rencontriez-vous?
In 1977,
I
started working at the Peang Thamo dam site.
I would report to Taval
every evening concerning the completion of the soy, which was done by the workers.
I would report to him every evening.
Did you also report to Taval in 1976 when you were building the Kambor and Kuk Ramchek dams?
Les barrages de Kuk Ramchek et de Kambor.
Answer. I did not report to Taval when I was working at the Kambor dam work site
because Taval was directly involved in the work. Taval était directement impliqué dans le travail.
Concerning Kuk Ramchek dam work site, I did not report to him every time I did I submitted the report to him only when he arrived at the Gorumche dam website.
Venait sur le site de Gorumche.
Let me just try to clarify that a little more, Mr. Witness. And I'm talking here about 1976, when you were working on the Cambo and Kok Rumchek dams. Who was your immediate superior during that time? Was it Taval or was it someone else?
Answer. When I was working at Kambao and Kokromche dam work sites, it was Taval who was my immediate supervisor.
Taval qui était mon superviseur immédiat.
And what was Taval's position in 1976 and 1977?
Quelle était la fonction de Taval en 1976 et 1977?
Taval. Answer. He was the chief of Sector 5 mobile unit. He was in charge of Sector 5.
Du secteur 5. Il était responsable du secteur 5.
Were you one of Taval's deputies?
Question, étiez-vous l'un des les adjoints de Taval?
Answer. I was not the deputy chief. I told you a while ago that I was considered a commander of the battlefield within a Sector 5 mobile force.
J'étais considéré comme commandant du champ de bataille au sein de la force de
l'unité. Let me read another past statement of yours, Mr. Witness. This is again from your DC CAM interview, E39094, Khmer ERN 00734044, English 00728651, a French 01123615. Question. Taval was
Question.
The chief. How many deputies were
Taval
there?
Était le chef.
Answer, only me.
Seulement moi.
Mr. Witness, if you weren't Taval's deputy
Monsieur
in 1976
si
and 1977, who was? 1977,
alors qui était l'adjoint?
There were no deputy chiefs within units of Taval. There was only chief, that is Taval, and as I said, I was simply the commander of the battlefield, and I would replace him once in a while when he was absent. As I told you already, there was only chief of the Sector 5, that is Taval,
and Taval.
As far as everyone was concerned, everything was dependent on Taval.
Tout le monde dépendait de Taval.
Was there anyone else who replaced Taval when he was absent, or was it just you who replaced him when he wasn't there?
Lorsque ce dernier était absent?
Answer. Whenever he was absent, the chief or chiefs of battalions or regiments would be in charge of their workforces when
de
Taval
leur force
was absent.
De travail, lorsque Taval était absent.
All right. You've referred to yourself as someone who was a commander of the battlefield. Can you explain to us why military terms like battlefield were used in relation to projects to build dams?
d'édification de barrages.
I have no idea,
Mr. Co-Prosecutor.
Je n'en sais rien, Monsieur le Co-Procureur.
I was a former soldier at the time.
J'étais un ancien soldat.
Mentioned
à l'époque, j'ai entendu les gens parler
so I used
d'un champ de bataille, donc j'ai utilisé le terme.
And at the time, as far as you are concerned, the elderly would be regarded as ta or
les
grandfather.
Plus âgées and the workplaces,
work sites where we were working or were called
battlefields.
And within the battlefields, there were chiefs of
et
battalions and regiments.
Il y avait des chefs de bataillon et des chefs de régiment.
There were also commanders of battlefields who were in charge of measuring the land and conducted the observation of the fields. And as I said, the elderly would be addressed by others as grandfather or ta in command.
Let me read to you the answer you gave to this question to DC CAM. This is an E3/9094, Khmer 00734050, English 00728655, French 0112-3619. Was your words or explanation in response to the same question to DC CAM? Quote, we just talked in military terms. If we talk about troops, we supervised the mobile unit like we were supervising troops. To fight in the battlefield in Cambodge was building dams and canals. They were called battlefields. We fought at the first battlefield in Cambore Dam. We would determine a win over it by completing it in a certain number of months. And we had to supervise the forces to make sure it was finished as planned. It was impossible if you could not finish it. End of quote. Mr. Witness, did you and Taval receive instructions to supervise the sector mobile forces like you were supervising troops, military troops?
No, Bill Rip Jumps Marpum and Opomboni.
When we were preparing for the battlefield at Kambao Dam worksite, for instance,
lorsque nous nous préparions sur
the instructions from the top would be for a period of 4 months to complete the dam
worksite.
And
Taval
would convene chiefs of regiments
les chefs de
in a meeting and
à une réunion
told all chiefs that the upper echelon wanted us, all of us, to complete
the worksite
for 4 months. And he would ask whether or not everyone was courageous enough to make a commitment to the dam worksite.
Since
chiefs of regiments and those people wanted to be promoted or gain favor, they would say they could complete the work site of war only 3 months.
Le barrage même en 3 mois.
So, when they decided to complete the work site for only 3 months, that would have the negative consequences on
il y avait des répercussions
workers.
Négatives pour les travailleurs.
And This, as I said, would affect the workers.
Comme je le disais, il y avait des conséquences pour les travailleurs.
So as I said, although the upper echelon wanted all of us to complete the Danville site for 4 months, and the chiefs of regiments would say that they could complete the work site for only 3 months.
And you just said that trying to complete the dam in 3 months had negative consequences or effects on the workers. What were the negative consequences or effects on the workers?
President Witness, please hold on.
And Councilor Consemon, you have the floor.
Consemon, thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Président.
Please direct the co-prosecutor to identify the location. Because if my understanding is correct, the witness has not mentioned that location yet.
Le témoin n'a pas encore parlé de cet endroit.
Mr. President, I'm asking the witness general questions about the dams that he was involved in building. So he's providing testimony here not about a specific dam, but about his experience with all the dams. So I'm not. This is not a question about a specific dam. It's about his experience as someone who has worked on multiple dams in Sector 5. So my question, Mr. Witness, you said that having to build the dams in 3 months had negative consequences for the workers. But what were those negative consequences?
Le président.
President Councilor Consemon.
Maître Consemon, vous avez la parole.
Consemon, thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, président.
Again, I'd like to object to this question.
Une fois de plus, je m'oppose à la question.
The question by the Deputy International Co-Prosecutor 6, Anna Sampson, to be made by the witness.
Témoin à faire des suppositions.
The witness responded to his last question.
Le témoin a répondu
and
à sa dernière
now
question.
The deputy co-prosecutor asked, what happened if within that period?
Que
so it's a leading question
si.
And six and a Samson from the witness.
Hypothétique, et on avait le témoin.
Mr. President, I'm asking the witness to explain his own words. It was
je
the witness who said that this had negative consequences for the workers. I'm asking him to explain what he meant.
Je lui demande d'expliquer ce qu'il voulait dire par là.
President, the objection by the Defense Council is overruled. This question wants to elicit the response from the witness regarding his personal experience, and the witness can respond to this kind of question, and the Chamber also would like to hear his response. For that reason, the witness is instructed to respond to the last question by the Deputy Co-Prosecutor. Witness.
Le témoin.
In fact, we are committed to achieve the work plan ahead of the time limit. For that reason, we needed to work harder.
Et c'est pourquoi nous devions travailler plus
Let
fort.
Me give you an example.
Je vais vous donner
if
un exemple.
The work quota is 2
si
cubic meters per day, and if we thought or believed that it would not be ready before the set time, then we needed to push ourselves to do 3 cubic meters per day. And that's my personal observation, and it was not strictly set in stone by
ANCAR.
Let me give you another example. The work plan was set for 4 months, but we determined to have it completed within 3 months. And if we were to follow Anka's plan, we would not exhaust ourselves, since it's much easier for us to complete it in a 4 month time limit. But we pushed ourselves a bit harder, and we could complete it within 3 month time frame.
Nous avons réussi à achever les travaux en 3 mois.
Thank you. You gave the same response, similar information to DC CAM on the same pages as the prior quote that I just read from document E3-9094. You talked about how situations where the plan was 4 months, but commanders committed to finish in 3 months. And at the very end of your DC CAM answer, you made the following statement about that. Quote, they wanted the strong ones. Therefore, the people had to suffer extremely.
End of quote.
In regards to this issue of building dams in 3 months rather than 4 months, what did you mean when you said they wanted the strong ones?
To work harder, it means we wanted to achieve the work quota before the set time limit.
Terminer les travaux avant la date prévue. C'est pourquoi nous
travaillons
plus fort.
So each regimental commanders would like
Chaque
to work harder so that they could maintain their position within the workforce.
Maintenir leur poste, leur position.
Did commanders who were able to build dams in 3 months instead of 4 months receive promotions within the regime?
Ont reçu des promotions par le régime?
In the regime, those who were in charge to lead people to
work, régime, ceux qui commandaient des gens,
and when
des
they could complete the work plan,
lorsqu'ils achevaient le
then they
plan
would
de travail,
be promoted, for instance, from battalion to regimental level, and they
régiment.
Could be labeled as the special force.
Et pouvaient recevoir
and
le titre
wherever
de force spéciale.
A work needs to be done quickly, then
Quand
they would be sent
rapide,
to that work site.
C'est eux qu'on enverrait sur le chantier.
During the Democratic Kampuchea regime, Mr. Witness, did you hear of or know what the central committee of the party was.
Saviez-vous, aviez-vous entendu parler
Did you know
du comité
the central committee
du parti?
Of the party?
Étiez-vous au courant de l'existence du comité central?
I heard people
Réponse.
Talking about it, but
J'ai
I
entendu
myself
des gens
didn't know
en parler,
who was
mais je ne
the
savais
committee
pas moi qui siégeait sur ce comité
or the central committee of the party.
Central du parti.
And of course, I did not know whether they referred to a body or refer to a group
Et
of people.
Je ne savais
people.
Pas ici s'il faisait référence à une entité ou un groupe de personnes.
What did you hear about the central committee and what did you understand
au sujet du comité
its role to be?
Quel était son rôle d'après votre compréhension à l'époque?
The central committee of the party was the top
Le
echelon of the party,
du parti était l'échelon
although
suprême
I
du
did not
parti.
Know who were in that committee.
Mais je ne sais pas qui était sur ce comité.
Their names.
Je ne connaissais pas leur nom.
I only heard of it. In fact, Initially, I thought it was a legal body and not a group of people. And only when the Vietnamese arrived in 1979, then I knew that there were people at the committee and there was Pol Pot. But during the regime, nobody knew who Pol Pot was. And as I said, only when the Vietnamese arrived in Cambodia, then we learned about the names of those people. And I only heard people refer to those names.
Do you remember during the Democratic Kampuchea regime hearing the term Great Leap Forward? Did you hear party leaders use the words Great Leap Forward? And what did you, if so, what did you understand that to mean?
Si c'est le cas, qu'en aviez-vous compris?
Je
n'ai jamais entendu cette expression grand bond en avant.
In my mobile unit, I did not hear people using that word.
Personne n'a utilisé cette expression.
If the word was used in the cooperative or the district, then
si c'était peut-être utilisé dans les coopératives ou les districts, je n'étais pas au courant.
Do you know whether the top leaders of the party had a policy to build dams and irrigation projects throughout the country as quickly as possible?
Le plus rapidement possible.
Did you ever hear that?
Avez-vous jamais entendu cela?
No, I did not know about their policy.
Non, je ne savais rien de leur politique.
I focused on the task at
moi,
hand.
Je me concentrais sur la tâche qu'on m'avait donnée, si on me donnait
but
une
I did
tâche
not
d'arpentage,
know about their
c'est ce que je faisais, mais je ne savais rien des politiques.
I want to refresh your recollection by referring you, reading to you, from a couple of documents from back in 1977 that relate to the Trappieng Tama Dam, Mr. Witness. The first is document E3, 1783, ERNs Khmer 00659260, English 00498181, French 00606766. Mr. Witness, this is a December 1977 article from a Chinese news agency reporting on a trip of a Chinese leader to the Trappieng Tama Dam. And it reports a statement from Northwest Zone Secretary Ross Nim that the Trappieng Tama Reservoir, and I quote, was built in less than 2 months this year by the people of the 5th region of the Northwest Zone in response to the call of the Party Central Committee to build water conservancy projects in a big way. End of quote. Does this refresh your memory, Mr. Witness, about any policy or instructions that were provided to the zone by the Central Committee? Were you aware of any instructions from the Central Committee regarding the construction of dams?
To respond to your question,
réponse.
I did not see
pour répondre à votre question,
No, any Chinese delegation visiting the Bianchimo Dam website. I myself did not know anyone from the Central Committee of the Party visiting the site.
Je n'ai pas eu connaissance que des membres du comité central du parti ont visité, sont venus en visite sur le barrage.
And moi, je connaissais Taval. Knowledge was based on what he told
et
us.
Ce que je savais,
did not know anything at all
de
about the central committee
je
of the
rien
party.
Du comité central du parti.
You told a DC CAM that you had, in 1975 to 1976, a responsibility in Prenet Pre commune for supervising the youth in that area. Did you know of a party publication, a monthly magazine called Revolutionary Youth?
No,
réponse.
I did not see it. So it
je
means that
vu.
I did not read it. And even if
Donc
I might have seen it, I did not read it because my knowledge in reading is very limited.
J'ai une connaissance très limitée de. Je lis très mal.
Mr. President, with your leave, I'd like to show the witness
the
copy of the July-August 1977 issue of Revolutionary Youth. It's document E3-771, E3-771, to see if he recognizes the cover page and whether he has seen, whether he saw documents like this at any time during the regime.
Un tel document sous le régime.
President, yes, you may proceed.
Oui,
Mr. Witness, this is a black and white photocopy of a document from 1977. And I understand your testimony that you did not read these publications. Did you ever see these documents, either Revolutionary Youth or Revolutionary Flag, in any of the offices where you worked?
Dans les bureaux où vous avez travaillé.
Well,
réponse.
Worked there. I did not see.
Quand j'ai travaillé là-bas,
this, flag magazine.
Je n'ai jamais vu ce magazine avec des drapeaux.
I never saw this kind of a document.
Je n'ai jamais vu ce type de document.
I may have some questions later on that, but I'll read them to you as there are some statements in there specifically relating to the Trappier Dam that we'll come back to. Let's turn now to a few questions I have relating specifically to the Cambor and Cook Rumchek dams that you've identified as projects you worked on. When was it that you worked on those two dams, Mr. Witness?
À la construction de ces deux barrages.
The exact time.
Je ne me souviens pas exactement de la date.
At those work sites.
à laquelle j'ai travaillé.
However,
sur ce
I might recall it by season.
Mais peut-être je me
souviens
de, la saison.
The Combao work site, it was when the water started to recede.
Les eaux ont commencé à se retirer.
It could meant I started working
Donc,
there in
mid-December. À la mi-décembre.
Or early January.
Début janvier.
That is for Kokrumcheik dam.
Au barrage de Kokrumcheik.
As for the Combao dam work site, I may have started working there by mid-December or late December.
Ou à la fin du mois de décembre.
Just to make sure I understand the time period here.
Le procureur, when you talk about
late December or early January, are you talking about December 1975 and January 1976? And if so, do I understand correctly that you worked on these dams at some point during the first half of 1976? Is that correct?
Pendant la première moitié de 76.
But
réponse.
Yes, it was in 1976.
Oui, c'était en 1976.
However, I did the land measurement.
Mais quand j'ai été envoyé à l'arpentage,
might be in late 1975.
Peut-être à la fin de l'année 75 quand je suis allé mesurer.
How many workers were assigned to build those two dams?
Travailleurs ont été affectés à la construction de ces deux barges.
I was assigned to be the battlefield commander to lead the force to work there.
I
actually was part of a group of six
people.
We initially measured the land. So after a group of six of us measured the land and the land plot, then the work forces came from various districts and cooperatives to work at the dam work site.
Were the Sector 5 mobile forces used for both these dams? And can you tell us how many people were in the Sector mobile forces in
1976?
The workforce in 1976.
When
we started working on the Combao Dam, the total 6,500.
Il y avait au total 6,500 personnes sur le chantier.
And can you tell us, give us a sense of how big these dams were? What was the length of the Cambor and Kokrumcheik dams? And how long were you given to complete the construction of those dams?
Terminer les travaux de construction.
The Combao dam was 13 kilometers long,
and
the
base
was 10 meters.
La base était de 10 mètres.
The crest was 5 meters,
5 mètres de large.
And the height was between 1.5 to 2 meters, depending on the level of the water.
Tout dépendant du niveau de l'eau.
And for the canal, the base was 5 meters and the crest was 10 meters. That's for the Combao dam. For the other dams, the length was 18 kilometers. With the same basement and crest.
Avec la même base et la même crête.
Ah, non, le...
And I refer again to the same, the basement crest for both the dam and the canal.
And for those two dams, how long were, how long was the sector mobile forces given to complete the construction of those dams?
For the Gombao Dam project, we were told to complete it before the New Year.
On nous a dit qu'il fallait terminer les travaux avant le nouvel an.
However, for the Gokrumchek Dam, which was 18 kilometers long, the time limit was the same. We had to complete it before the New Year, and the workforce for the Gokrumchek Dam was around 4,000. However, we were given three excavators to work at that dam. And I proceeded at the Gokrumchek Dam according to the time schedule, as I could not force them to work to complete it before the set time.
Nous avons respecté as there was a different workforce at the Gokrumchek Dam than at the Gombao Dam. Le groupe de travailleurs n'était pas le même qu'à Gokrumchek qu'à Gombao.
And do I understand correctly when you say you had to complete it by New Year, you're referring to the Khmer New Year in April, what would have been April 1976. Is that right?
Yes, we had to complete the work before the Khmer New Year.
Nous devions terminer les travaux
as the Khmer New Year usually falls during the dry season. And that is different from the Chinese. Usually the Chinese celebrate their New Year in January.
Is it correct then that for both of these dams, you were expected to build them in 3 or 4 months? Do I understand correctly?
In a sense, that is correct.
Oui, en un certain
however,
sens,
because the length of the Gokrumchek Dam was longer, that is 18 kilometers, so the Gombao Dam work site had to be completed first. And of course, we committed to finish that dam first. But we couldn't guarantee that the Gokrumchek Dam, which was 18 kilometers long, could be completed within the set time limit.
I wanted to ask you, Mr. Witness, in terms of the general work conditions and procedures, was the construction of the Khambor and Gokrumchek dams the same as construction of Trapyang Tama Dam, or were there differences in how the work conditions and procedures between those three dams? Specifically, for example, work hours and quotas.
Did
workers have the same work hours and quotas at all three dams that you worked at, Khambor, Gokrumchek, and Trapyang Tama, or did workers have different hours and conditions at each site?
Regarding the three dams work size, the working hours were the same.
Les
we started in the early morning and we rested at noon
ensuite,
and we resumed at 1:30 or sometimes 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
À 13h30 ou 14h.
And for the sector mobile unit, each worker was given 3 cans of rice.
Chaque travailleur and we had 3 meals
per day.
And
each, for each meal, we received a can of rice.
Donc pour
each.
Chaque repas, on recevait une canette de riz.
And what about work quotas? Were they the same at all three dams?
Étaient-ils les mêmes sur les trois chantiers?
No, the work quota for the three dam work sites was different.
Ce n'étaient pas les mêmes quotas de travail.
Because Tropiantmo dam work site was huge in scale and distance. And the Kambao and Kokurumchek dams were smaller and not far from the, where the earth was dug.
Très loin de là où l'on creusait la terre.
For instance, at Kokurumchek dam,
exemple, à Kokurumchek,
we could carry a full basket of dirt.
On pouvait transporter un panier.
In a shorter time than at the Tropiantmo dam work site due to the distance.
Car la distance qui séparait le
for the true small dam work site,
it
took us quicker to carry
donc,
the dirt.
Autres barrages,
for example,
est,
we only
it,
the place where we had to dump the dirt was only a few meters away from we, where we had to carry the dirt
de là où on devait déposer la terre qui avait été creusée.
Thank you. We'll come back to talk about work quotas a little later. Specifically in regards to the Kokurumchek Dam, Mr. Witness, do you remember any dignitaries or party leaders coming to visit the Kokurumchek work site?
Sur le site du barrage de Kokurumchek.
Yes, there was the Kokurumchek dam.
Oui.
However, I did not know them.
Sur le barrage de Kokurumchek, mais je ne les connaissais pas.
I saw a vehicle and a man got
j'ai
out of the vehicle and observed
un homme
us working.
Nous a observé
he did not speak to anyone, nor
personne.
Did he call the regimental commanders to meet him.
Les commandants de régiment afin que ces derniers le rencontrent.
And after that, he got back into the vehicle and drove
après
off
cela,
to Phnomstrop district.
À bord du
I did not know which encart he represented. And that was an occasion that I saw this vehicle with a man getting off and watching us working there.
Voilà, j'ai juste vu un
President,
homme
thank you, Deputy Co-Prosecutor, thank you, Mr. Witness. It is now convenient for
President,
us to have a lunch break.
We
take a break now and resume at 1:30 this afternoon. Could the officer please assist the witness during the lunch break and invite him as well as his duty counsel back into the courtroom at 1:30 this afternoon. Security personnel, you are instructed to take his phone to the waiting room downstairs and have him returned to attend the proceedings this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now in recess.